Hello, welcome back to my channel where we're going to be singing, where I'm going to be doing some more videos to review. Now, the lineup we have today is very cool. We are starting off today with...
Sweden.
Now, I knew that. So, Sweden, in my opinion, sort of like own Eurovision. In a way. Sweden, I don't know, they have put in so much effort every year. I mean, the Melody Festival that they have over there.
The what?
Melody Festival. Melody Festivalen.
Yeah. Festivalen. They're annoying
the Melody, the Melody Festivalen that they have over there. This massive competition. I mean, it's equatable to like the X Factor. It's huge. Yeah. I mean, they've won many times.
They're putting a lot of effort every year.
Yeah, their music scene is huge as well. So like, big contenders. Now, recently, I actually sang in Sweden. I went to Malmo, and it was so cool. People in Sweden are so nice. And Malmo was so beautiful. You should go. Unless you're from Malmo, then like, hey neighbor. Yeah. And there's loads of gay flags, so hey boys.
What's your favorite song from Sweden?
That's an easy question with an easy answer. Måns Zelmerlöw, is that his name? Yeah, it's so fun. I remember when that song won, I was playing Grand Theft Auto 5. It's a great game, you should buy it. And I was listening to it in my headphones.
Great story.
What's your favourite?
Euphoria.
Euphoria!
I know the lyrics to any song that exists on this air.
Oh, I dribbled out my nose. Okay. So, this song is called Move, and it's by the Mamas. Yes, Mama. Okay, the Mamas, Move, Sweden. Let's see how you do. Ooh, is it a band?
It's
the Mamas. Oh, I love that. Come on, harmonies. That was some fun vocals. I like this choreography. This is really effective. It's cool. This is very angelic and gospel. Kind of reminds me of last year's actually a little bit. This is cool. Now, you know what? This is gonna be a fun song. This is gonna be, everybody in the auditorium is gonna be obsessed. They're all equally good at singing as well so far, which is good. It's not like a sort of Beyonce and the girls situation. It's like, they're all a band. I mean, this what the song is about is very like typical, you know, like, I love you, there's nothing in the way of my love, but it's such a feel-good song, and it's kind of what you want, really. I love these kind of breaks where you got a clap in the background and everyone's like, yeah, it's great. We're moving mountains. Those three girls have so much charisma. Yes. That is, come on mama. Come on mamas. They've all got strong vocals. This is gonna hold its own. Sweden know what they're doing. You do it for me too, yeah. I want to be in their band.
You look a bit out of place.
Oh, That was so fun.
Yeah.
That was fun.
I know, that proper cheered us up.
So, okay, it's kind of hard to explain. When I write a song, sometimes bits don't fit, sometimes parts of it need tweaking, so maybe it's like, you know, the verse doesn't match the chorus, whatever. This song, first thing I hear when I hear it is it's a well-rounded song. Like, it feels like all the pieces of the puzzle, like, fit in this song. Does that make sense? So that's what I feel straight away. I've heard this song, all in all, it's a perfect, well-rounded song, and I'm not surprised because, I mean, it's from Sweden, and they're good at doing that. The Mamas, I love that name. That is so, so charismatic, so cool. Their personalities, like, pour out on stage. Their vocals are all very... I mean, they have these, like, harmonious moments, and it sounds very gospel, and it just makes you want to get up and be like, yes, this is my jam. So yeah, like, they do feel like your friend, they feel like, you know, you could just hang out. I didn't have any negatives for this song. I don't think it's gonna win. I'm gonna put that out there. I don't think it's gonna win. Yeah. I've heard so many great songs this year. This was fun and so fun, but I don't think it had the winning, oh my god, blow me away sort of thing. Yeah, once I've done all of these, I'm gonna put, like, who I think's gonna win, and then... Oh my god, and then I should place a bet, and if I win, I could become a millionaire. Yeah. So the one thing is, I don't know if I like the staging, so I think they get a bit lost a bit. Like, they've got these beautiful black gowns on, but then the backdrop is black, and they've got these, like, tiny lights here, there, and everywhere. But then again, you know, maybe in this way it's kind of like you are focusing on the voice. I don't know. But then again, they've got such a big personality, so it's like, have an outfit to match.
Maybe white. Or like a white backdrop.
I think a rainbow. Sweden, I really like that song. Yeah, I got the hiccups. I think it's gonna do really well. Like I said, I don't think it's gonna win, but I think it's gonna do really well, and I'm really excited to see that live on stage. Next up, who have we got?
Bulgaria.
Bulgaria. So I read somewhere that Bulgaria is currently leading at the odds, which means this song better be good. Bulgaria have had some good songs in the past. I mean, I remember when they came second, when Portugal won?
Yeah, I think so.
Beautiful, I think the song was called. Mm. I was obsessed with that. Oh my god, I was obsessed. And the funny thing is before that, I never really noticed Bulgaria on the leaderboard. That was the first time that I thought, oh my god, that is a song I would listen to. Yeah, I'm excited to see what they're bringing. So today we have Victoria. Your mum's name. She didn't tell me she was participating in Eurovision. Crazy. And the song is called Tears Getting Sober. Tears Getting Sober. This is kind of like Romania, isn't it? Alcohol year, Tears Getting Sober.
Oh, yeah.
What alcohol theme, isn't there? Ooh, Starry Night. Is it gonna start or...? Ooh, these chords are very fun. It's not like powerful or leading to a really heavy chorus, but it's just so listenable. Her vocals, she's not the type that's like a belter or a pusher with how she's singing, but she's got so much control and a beautiful tone, and it's really melancholic. The music video is wow cool. I know I said this about the other song, but this is so Billie Eilish.
Oh, Romania.
I said it about Romania, yeah, but this is way more.
Yeah, I think that's...
I mean, Billie Eilish is huge. I mean, if you pull inspirations from her, I don't blame you. People love it. And I mean, I love this, so...
Do you?
Yeah, I really, really love this so far. I mean, I love Billie Eilish, and this is very with her hums in the background of harmonies and her subtle vocals. It's all just masterpiece. I said before, you know, a lot of ballads can get lost, and there's quite a lot of ballads this year, but some of them are just so uniquely beautiful on their own, they're not going to get lost. And when you release a song like this, so nice.
Magical music video.
It's very magical, and you can hear in the instruments, it's like just feels very magical. Aww.
Did you like it?
Yeah, I really love that. I can, after listening to that now, I know that I'm gonna go to work tomorrow and listen to that on my headphones.
Ah, that's your first overwhelmingly positive reaction to a song like them, like honest?
No, I had the same reaction with Italy. In fact, whilst I was listening to this, I was thinking about Italy's song, because they're both ballads and they're both phenomenal, but they're both very different. And in fact, it wouldn't surprise me if the top two songs so far from what I've heard would be Bulgaria and Italy battling.
Really?
Yeah.
I know we said that there's so many ballads and they might get lost between each other, but that ballad, Bulgaria's ballad, is the one that will make the rest of them get lost, I think.
Yeah.
It's so good.
And as a musician myself, and I'm sure many of you watching might be the same, it's like, I'll hear a song like that and I'll think, I wish I wrote that. Or like, I'll hear a song like that and I'll be like, I'm gonna use that as an inspiration for me writing a song next. You know, like songs like that, which are so overwhelmingly beautiful, really do have an impact. Bulgaria did not participate in 2014 and 2015, is that correct?
Yeah.
And they came back with a bang after that. They came fourth and they came second, then they did not participate again last year, and so there could be a pattern. So when they come back this year with such a beautiful, beautiful song, I mean, maybe they'll beat second, maybe they'll come third. I want to desperately re-listen to it now. I want to re-listen to it and listen to the lyrics again and listen to, like, watch the music video again. Okay, so next up we've got
Serbia.
So the last time that I remember Serbia winning, was this the last time that Serbia won in 2006?
Seven.
I remember them winning. That was like the second year I started watching Eurovision. Serbia are known for their Balkan ballads, and I think they usually write in their language, don't they? So that's pretty good. I can't really, I mean, to be honest with you, no specific song comes to mind when I think of Serbia. I don't have any like recent standouts in my brain for Serbia, so I'm excited to hear what they have to offer this year. So I haven't heard any songs from the Balkans yet, have I?
I think Slovenia and Albania. I don't know if Albania is considered Balkan, so.
But I don't think that Slovenia is going to do very well in the competition this year, actually, so I'm looking forward to hearing Serbia to see if they have a bigger chance to bring the Balkans into the top of the competition! Thank you. I'm here all night. So this is, ooh, Hasta la Vista, baby, by Hurricane. Serbia. That's Spanish, right? Okay, this is Hasta la Vista, Hurricane. Ooh, sex. That's what I'm getting from it. Bum bum ba dum bum bum. Oh my god. I like that. Is this in Serbian? It's not English, is it?
I think so.
This is very, like, Eurovision-y. I mean, you can feel the build. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. hasta la vista, baby. Okay, well, the chorus is fun. Maybe it's not my type of song that I'd listen to, like I said before, with the other sort of Eurovision-y sounding song. But yeah, take this for what it is. This is very fun. I reckon that in the when this is on stage, if they're like crunking out the dance moves, that this is gonna go down pretty well with people. I actually don't mind the melody line of the verses. I like how they're playing with neon in the music video, that's cool. It's quite catchy, isn't it? Hasta la vista, baby! Do you know what? It kind of like reminds me of Little Mix.
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, like maybe like a cross. It's very girl bandy.
But like the bottom.
Yeah. I have to say, I can actually hear this like in the sort of chart music. Yeah.
Here?
Yeah. I can.
Not in England.
Yes.
What
can't you hear it? Hasta la vista, baby. Cool. So, yeah. Look, you got to take these sort of songs face value as they are, and they are very Eurovision-y, very pop-y, very commercial, and very enjoyable. I mean, I would dance to this, and I would definitely crunk it. The song that it reminded me of in my head, I'm going to sing it, it goes, eh, reminded me of that song. Is it gonna win? Probably not. I don't think that this is a winning song, especially after hearing songs with such depth and you know, a lot of the ballads. But it was definitely a very enjoyable one, and I don't see any reason why people won't enjoy this or have huge negative critiques. Cool. Next up, who have we got?
Moldova.
Now, I've got a little story for you, dear Moldova. Got a funny little story. But so back in 2017, 2018, I actually wrote a song and performed in the national finals for Moldova. I'll have you know. Once upon a time, you were all mine. My favorite song of all time ever in Eurovision is from Moldova, which may be controversial because they've never won. But Aliona Moon sang a song called Omia?
It's your favourite song ever, so you should know.
And I don't know why, but there was something about that song that blew my mind and I loved it. Anyway, so I took it upon myself to write a song for Moldova. Yes, I wrote a song, I went over to Moldova, I travelled there, I recorded the song with a girl over there. Shout out to Sandy C, you know who you are. And we shot music videos and we sang it live and we had a blast. And then we performed in the national finals. Unfortunately, we didn't win. That was the year the Dorados won. Oh my god, I had the best experience of my life over there. And I had so much fun. And I had so much Moldovan food. Oh my god, and I had so much Moldovan wine, because apparently they've got like the biggest distillery in the world there. Funnily enough, actually, I was given some cognac from the guys that I was staying with over there. And we drank that the other day, didn't we?
Yeah.
Moldovan people. So I was trying to tell him that when you're in Moldova, you drink cognac and coke. And so we had cognac and coke, and he said it was weird.
It was actually quite good though.
It was good. So put in the comments, is that a thing, or did I make it up? Cognac and coke. Okay, So, I've got good memories of Moldova. I have a lot of songwriter friends that write songs for their national finals. And I know that there's so many talented singers over there because I've worked with and spoke to a couple. So I'm really rooting for you guys. Don't let me down.
Okay.
So this is by Natalia Gordienko.
Natalia.
Oops. So this is Natalia Gordienko, and this is Prism. Here we go. Da, 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 da. Yeah. I'm really excited to hear this. I usually follow the national finals for Moldova, so I had to like intentionally not follow it this year. Wow, at least not this one. She's got a cute voice. I really don't like this song very much so far, I have to say. The melody line is quite dated, it sounds. Doesn't feel like it belongs in the 2020 playlist. She's got a great voice though, I have to give her that. It does feel quite blocky though. We've had first chorus, third chorus, and it feels like we're back to a verse again. I think Moldova sometimes does this. They have a great singer, but then they send a mediocre song. I mean, last year with Stay, Anna, I mean, she actually performed when I was over there in the national finals, but didn't get through that yet. And I remember thinking her vocals were amazing, but then she won their national finals and sang Eurovision last year with a very mediocre song, I thought. And it's almost like they've done it again. I like this bit. It's really weird actually because now I've said it, I can't unhear it. This is such a dated song. I can hear this in Eurovision, but from years ago, like in the noughties. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's weird. That's so weird. It feels like I've gone back in time.
Yeah, that's what I get as well.
Now I've already said about how much I love Moldova and I try not to be biased, but I didn't really like that song at all. I thought that was very dated, and even if I was listening to this song when I feel like the era it would fit, I don't think I would still like it.
Yeah.
Her voice was great. Not the best voice I've ever heard. Like last year, her voice, I think, Anna, was phenomenal, but I don't have that lasting effect with her. So yeah, I'm really sorry, Moldova guys, but that song was it was not for me. I don't think it's gonna do well. In fact, you know, I don't even think that's gonna qualify to the finals. I know the singers over there and I know some of the songwriters and I know that there's so much more potential over there. I mean, there's some phenomenal singers and some phenomenal songwriters and they come out with a song like that. I just don't understand it. Oh well. Thank you for joining me again on this. Oh, I've gone all posh. Thank you for joining me again. I hope to see you back here again, but not literally, because that means that I'd be infiltrating the security system and looking at you through your camera. Hey.
Groovy.
Don't forget to let me know in the comments below if you agree or disagree with my opinions. Which songs do you think you're gonna do well? Which songs do you think maybe won't do so well? And don't forget to like and subscribe. Love. Bye. We're going up. Is that the word?
Yeah.
We're going up.
She doesn't say up in every single, she's saying we're going up.
We're going up.
That's terrible.
Okay.